I got hooked on this field in one class. I knew what I wanted to do after one class. Part of the reason I was always happy to be doing this sort of work was because I love to be outdoors, and I was, you know, I hike, backpack, I like to spend time on rivers anyway, and a lot of the field work that I've done is overlaps so much with what I was doing in my personal life that it was just a really fun, easy fit for me. And I was always really interested in just questions about how the Earth works, and I always knew I wanted to be a scientist. I mean, from when I was really young, what form it took sort of developed as I got into more recreational activities when I got older.
Four. 11.
I didn't start learning whitewater kayaking until I started working on rivers, because I would see groups of kayakers go by in the Grand Canyon and just thought, oh, that looks like so much fun. I've got to work on my kayaking skills and get better so that I can run really fun rivers. I've actually gotten to bring my family to a couple of places that I've worked. It's just been really fun. My husband and I did a backpacking trip in the Grand Canyon about 4 years ago, and we were collecting data for one of my projects during a five-day backpacking trip. The Elwha project was so much fun for a lot of reasons, because it's one of the biggest environmental restoration projects in the country. You hear so much bad news about the environment, and it was an example of people doing something really, really neat that was positive for the environment, and to be able to study the changes that happened there as a result was so much fun. My son was about 9 months old. My husband hiked him in to every one of our survey reaches, and we have pictures of him helping us out in a survey on the Elwha River, eating seaweed on the beach that didn't used to be there before they took the dams out. It's a project that a lot of people get excited about, whether or not they understand very much about the ecosystem or the physical processes that we study. It doesn't matter. I mean, people just get so excited to think, oh, we've done something really neat to restore this beautiful place. It would be amazing to go back there and see salmon swimming through our control site. And I always thought I would cry with happiness if that happened.
Ow!